No.
And not being prepared. So again, when you said used to play, you play your money, or you do play your money out. So I kind of stopped doing as much, but if like a 2-3 year stretch, I had all my paychecks 2 years ahead, and I was playing out saying, all right, Mother's Day for that money, or
I wish I could do that. I never did that.
Yeah, her birthday, or you know, my birthday trip, yeah, or whatever. Anything down, like anything down to. And I would say I want this amount of money. And I would take off my money off the top. So I say I want to walk around with like 250. Mm. Take that off the top, whatever I was saving, and break everything down.
Everything I was done with you, whatever.
So my point is, though, and the first thing, I know everybody say they hate paying bills. In a weird, worth way, I actually like paying bills.
Me too.
Yeah, because
I got reason, but let me hear
it. It gets off my mind. I just like, I feel it's done. I'm over with. So first thing I do every time I get paid.
Let's pay the bills.
Pay the bills. I go in the bathroom, on the toilet, paying the bills, whatever. And I do what I do.
So, well, you do your shit in there.
Yeah, yeah.
The baby shit.
Exactly. Yeah, you're still going. You're still mad my drink. So I do that. So my point is, though, let's say it's Friday. I do that around like Friday, 6, 7 a.m., whatever. By the time I get to work, 12 o'clock, all my money is spent. I only have my walk around money. That's 100%. All I have. She will text me, yeah, so I forgot. Like, can you send me $500? I'm like,
what?
The money is gone. I only have my walk around money now. Everything's in the stocks or the savings or bills.
It's going.
Credit card shit is pending right now.
It's going.
I was like, I gotta take my savings money. Cause I don't my walk. That's all my. I only got $250.
Yeah.
$250 to the next check. Everything else is tucked away or whatever. Yeah, so. Yeah. Not prepared, but you told me this last week. Sure, I would have ducked the
fact, been prepared.
Put it together, cool. Take the 500, cause that's what y'all do. But yeah, the not prepared shit burned me.
No, so to your point, right? I want to just add context. Mm-hmm. I don't plan my money out because I'm an entrepreneur, and for the large part, I never even knew.
You account for it.
I account for my money on it. Like after a spit, I'm like, okay, this one here, this one there. I just started that maybe a little over a year ago as I started to grow to becoming a man in the house, because a lot of people don't understand. There's a difference between having a man in the house and being the man of the house. I'm the man of the house.
Okay.
So some women have a man in the house, but he's just a man in the house. I'm a man. I'm the man of the house, which means the finances are my responsibility to make sure that anything that could mess with in our future, mm-hmm. I'm responsible for tracking. Mm-hmm. So it's like for me, tracking our safety, tracking our spending habits, tracking like all of those things, our livelihood is the things that I'm making sure I lead from. So that's why I start to make sure I'm keeping account for everything. Cause like I said, I'm growing into that role of being able to lead. And one way that you have to be able to lead and as a man is, even if you don't have the most finances, mm-hmm. you need to be able to be financially responsible.
Sure.
And just being responsible as a man makes it easier to be a leader, because people know that they can trust your judgment, trust your guidance, trust your decision making, because they know it's coming from a responsible place and not a frivolous, selfish, or you know, self-centered space. Mm-hmm. So that's that. But to add context to what you just said about planning all your money, I wish I could get to that point where you're like, yo, all right, I know I got this amount of thousands or this amount of hundreds coming in, and I can pay this out, pay it out. That would make my life extremely easier, and I want to get to that. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? But that's something that I probably would just have to work towards. But as far as in, once the money is tucked away, baby, this money don't exist no more. I won't. If my girl asked me for $500, and I'm walking around my $250. You missed the bed. You missed the train. You should have taken me to that $556. Because by 7 o'clock, like you said, the moment, yo, I told my, yo, it's so funny, bro, that you say that. I say to my girl, I say, yo, you understand, my money is spent before I even get it, mm-hmm. because of the amount of responsibilities that I'm taking care of. So it's like, mm-hmm. I don't even have time to plan it out. It's like, soon as it, people do not know what it's like to, I basically work for my family, essentially. Like, I took my, one time my daughter asked me for $50, or maybe more, maybe it was either $50 or $150, mm-hmm. but I reserved the right for it to be either or.
Right.
It was at a time I just had dropped out of accountability. So I used to do this thing where when I'm doing my pre-orders on my first maybe 300-400 sales, I'm going to be the one that's dropping the book off or shipping it. So if you call me for a book, I'll pull up, take a picture with it, because I needed to do this for my marketing. Right. I need the people to see people purchasing the book, so it increases people's desire to purchase the book. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, ride with me right quick. I want to show her something. Let's just say it was $150 for the sake of this. I rode around for 7 hours to get to $150. Now, for the this wasn't the most proper use of my time, money-wise, mm-hmm. but it wasn't for money.
Right.
It was for the get the picture, to interact, to mm-hmm. sign the books. All of that was the reason why I did it. She was in the car asleep half the time. Mm-hmm. When I got to the $150, I handed it to her. I said, so I want you to understand that when you're asking me for money and I'm sending it to you and it get to you in 2.2 seconds, this is all of the stuff that I got to do in a day to get it. I don't want you to think I'm just pulling this money from thin air. This is what a day on a job of you just asking me for this money look like. And it made her in my opinion, felt like she respected the process, so she not just thinking like, oh, if he say no, he just being a jackass dad. It's like, no, like, when I say, baby, give me a day, give me 2 days, you gotta see what the fucking work looked like on the other end or how I had to get this money, so you won't be unappreciative of where this money came from. And I was like, would you want to ride around with me again? She's like, no. Like, it's like, yeah, I want you to see how I work for this. I drove from Chester to Delaware to New Jersey, literally, in that day. Now, I probably made like, I probably sold like 10 books at $30. I probably made like $300. Mm-hmm. But it wasn't even the time, was the driving.
Right, of course.
From 45 minutes to here to 30 minutes to 45 minutes to here, and I'm only picking up $30 at a time. $30 at a time. $30 at a time. So when I gave her that $150, she was just like, damn, that just took 7 hours to make that. So, baby, don't think that when you ask me for $700 worth of shit, understand how much time it might take me to make it. And be respectful of it.
Yeah, those conversations are great. I always look forward, because my baby's only turned 40 this year, so I look forward to having those just, like, real-life conversations. Conversation. Just, like, and everything don't necessarily have to be, like, a speech per se. But, you know, when I'm not giving you the 150, or I say give me a day or two, this is what I mean, this is how I feel about money, this is how should I be trying to explain to your mom and have conversation about facts. You know, you can give me, you know, your bullshit ass counter that your mom probably
counter. I was about to say
about my daughter.
I was about to say, no, I ain't got no counter. Damn, I know we was going at the debate.